Now, the Me Too movement was meant originally, as we just heard, to empower women and give some women the confidence, I guess, to call out sexism. Has it been derailed a little?
Absolutely. It's been given women license to destroy men on the basis of the most trivial accusations. I mean, one of my favourites was this Canadian MP who got upset. She was having a photo taken with two other MPs, two men on either side of her, and one of them made a joke saying, this wasn't the sort of threesome I had in mind. She said she was traumatised for 6 months. I mean, this is just madness, this stuff. Women calling out men and saying it was a Me Too accusation of sexual assault because he gave me bad sex. I mean, this has done, I mean, what started off as a really important issue has absolutely been derailed and given women the right to behave extremely badly and destroy men who have done something to upset them at any point.
Yeah, because as you say, it has brought a lot of positives. Women have been able to come out and call men out. So where has it gone wrong? Where has it, you know, gone off the rails?
Oh, I think because it's gone far too far. Now, most people would agree with that. But I'm not just talking about Me Too. I'm talking about a whole range of areas where feminism has gone off the rails. Feminism started off about equality, about promoting, you know, men and women having an equal playing field. And then now it's all about rules and regulations to advantage women at the expense of men. Constant male bashing, false accusations of violence being used to destroy men's lives, women denying men access to their children. There are endless rules in our society now which are about demonising men. And my call is to the mothers of sons to say, we have to look at what's happening to our boys. We have to look at what's happening to the men we love in our lives. That women have been given so much unfair power to destroy them if they like. Mm.
Well, you've spent three decades working as a psychologist and a sex therapist.
And mainly a writer.
And
yeah.
A writer. And so what are men saying to you? Because I know a lot of the men I know and love are quite scared at the moment.
Absolutely. Look, one of the things I'm doing at the moment is going out on campuses, talking about the fake rape crisis. Look at what's happening to young male students. We have universities across Australia setting up regulations where the universities are going to adjudicate rape cases. And this is all driven by feminists who are upset because juries won't convict a young man in a date rape case where they don't know who to believe. You know, it's a he said, she said. And so if they get them on the campuses and have the universities making decisions using a lower standard of proof, then young men can be thrown out of university. This is what happened in America. There's been innumerable males being thrown out of university, having their whole lives derailed, and they're trying to get it to happen here. And I spent last year defending a young PhD student, Adelaide University, who was being pursued by a university committee, and I got a barrister to represent him saying they had no right to get involved in a criminal law matter. This is what women who've got young sons going to university need to be out there speaking out about this. And that's what I've been doing. I've been on campuses across Australia, and I'm going to do it all next year, saying this is a fake rape crisis. There is no evidence that our universities are crawling with rapists. Mm. This is an attempt to demonise young men, and it's really dangerous.
As a mother of two sons, I know exactly what you're talking about. But also so many women, you know, professional women, don't want to call themselves feminists anymore. They are too scared to speak out. That shows you how far the pendulum has swung. But they won't say that publicly, will they?
No. The latest big survey just done in Australia, 19% say they're a feminist now. 45% think feminism has gone too far. 75% believe feminism applies to men too. And that's the other side of the story. That's what my book, hashtag Mentoo, is talking about. The issues we never discuss. What's happening to men out there? Why are boys doing so badly in schools when the whole curriculum is set up to advantage girls? Why do we have 60% of graduates of our universities women now? What's happening in the family courts that women have such power to shut men out of children's lives, to use false allegations of violence, to turf the man out of his home.
Yeah.
6 out of 8 people killing themselves every day in Australia are men. we need to start calling out feminism, which is a really destructive force in our society.
Bettina Arndt, well done. Good on you for writing.
Thank you.
It's called hashtag Mentoo. Check it out. Thank you.
You can buy it online. It's not quite out, but you'll be able to order it in time for Christmas. This is to tell Australia that Bettina is rooting for the men of Australia.
We'll put it on our website. Thank you.